Hello YouTube. Today we're looking at something very special. It's the Lloyd's LT612 transistorized reel-to-reel tape recorder from the mid-1960s. This is a very special machine because it is one of the first machines that I ever got to restore from eBay. This is going to a new home. I was contacted by a fellow Vietnam vet, and his name is Don. He has a large collection of these white Scotch reels. People would use this product made by Scotch. It was very popular, called Living Letters, and inside the case was the reel. Fill in the back here as a label, stick the postage on it, and throw it in the mail, and it would get to the other person. They'd play it, and then they could put a new label on, because the labels just simply were held in through tabs here, and you could go back and forth using vocal correspondence. It's very, very popular at the time, because what he wants to do is play the tapes back, and he also wants to put them into the computer. He wants to digitize them. Now, I know how to do that. This video is going to do is show you this tape recorder, how it was repaired. It's going to show you the inside of it, and then it's going to show you the operation. Now, the first thing we want to do is just take a tour of the machine. What we have here is a stop, control, rewind, play, and record. Obviously, the record has to be pressed down at the same time as play. I'm not going to do it because this is Don's tape. I don't want to erase his tape. To play, you just simply put it in play when it's turned on. I don't have the power on. And for rewind, you push this button here, and that'll rewind it. We'll look at that later on. Here is the on-off volume control, and here is the tone control. There is a post here for the capstan sleeve change. The capstan is under here. You change the speed by removing the sleeve, putting it here, and then this will play at a lower speed. It has two speeds, 3 3/4, which is the normal speed, and 1 7/8. This is very common at the time. This is an AC operated machine. So here's the power cord. There's no battery for it at all. The speaker is underneath it here at this angle, and there's no other inputs or outputs except on the side here, where you have a microphone input, an auxiliary input, and an earphone output. And when we work with the computer, we'll be using the earphone output. There is also on the back here a storage compartment, and that's where the wire gets wrapped up and stored, and also the microphone. It has its own companion microphone named Lloyd's. It's a dynamic microphone, and like all the microphones of the time, it's just a little square microphone that would stand up like that. I was lucky enough to get it with the original Lloyd's box, which is not in the best shape, but it was stored in this box for a very long time. And the box gives us information. It's a 6-transistor, 2-speed, portable tape recorder for 110, 117 volts, model LT612. Here we see the AC motor, and the coil for the motor also acts as a transformer to provide power to the amplifier here. And it drops enough of the voltage that this amplifier could actually run on batteries. In fact, this machine was also made in a battery / AC version, which used a DC motor instead of an AC motor. This is the record play switch, and here is the input and output jack area. What happened with this machine was, because of the gas that was produced by the effect of the wiring against the plastic inside the case, that gas is very corrosive. So it got into some of the electronic soldering connections, and I had to go through and double check them and replace them, and I had to replace a couple of capacitors because it wasn't that the capacitors had failed, It was that the actual connections, the legs on the capacitors, had been eaten through by the corrosive gas. So that was an issue that was a problem. Another issue with this is, while it's a very nice little quiet little motor, there's no fan on it. The fan that they have is built into the rotor on this part of the motor, but this gets quite warm. So the machine really does not work very well after about an hour or two of operation because it's so hot. So I would recommend just using it for an hour at a time and then let it cool off for an hour. The motor is here. Here's the central shaft. Obviously it's not a pulley, it's just the shaft of the motor. And it's going to either work the rewind table here, or it's going to work this idler, which is connected to the capstan flywheel, and then the capstan flywheel through a belt is connected to the lower plate on the friction clutch mechanism. And you see that the indicator light here came on. And that indicator light is a neon bulb running at 65 volts. It also acts as a record level indicator, flashes on and off. And the static that you heard when I turned the volume on and off has always been there. Everything I've done to clean this potentiometer has not worked. There's no way to replace this potentiometer because it has a special switch attached to it, so it has to be what it is. However, it does not cause any static during playback or anything. It's just at the beginning you have that problem, so you can see as I turn the knob there's no static. It's just at the very beginning that it does that. Now in the rewind, this is going to move towards the motor a little bit. So watch as I just, you see how it's moving a little bit? And now you can see that the rewind table is turning. And now it's free. Now when it's put in rewind, not only does it come closer to the motor, but this brake assembly pulls back so that it obviously is able to run free. And then when it's in stop, the brake assembly comes in contact with the tire. In forward, the idler wheel will come over slightly and go between the motor, and it stays with the capstan flywheel. Let's take a look at that. And as that turns the flywheel, which turns the lower plate on the friction clutch mechanism. And because there's a felt connection there, the table turns through friction. And this is weight controlled, very similar to the Sony TC-135. So the heavier the reel, the tighter it grips the table. It has no tape lifters. Here's the electric erase head, here's the electric record, obviously the electric record and playback head. So that's all there is to it. One thing that I want to show you is something that happened with this machine, and it happens with a lot of tape recorders. But this is such a great example of the problem. Look at this mark here, and all in here. I'm going to zoom in on that so you can see it better. You see all that scarring? That's the wiring. This is where the wire and the microphone are stored when the machine is put back together. The reason that's happening is because of an incompatibility between the wire jacket plastic and the plastic of the case. And what has happened is because it sat for so long over time, the contact point between the two materials created a chemical reaction. It looks as if somebody dragged a soldering iron over it, but in actual fact, it was a long-term, very, very long-term contact that was caused by the chemical incompatibility of the parts. Now, what happened over time is that because this was in a case, it was in its original box, which was sealed, the gas that is released from this reaction had nowhere to go. So it was inside the machine. This caused a lot of damage to the electronic components because the gas was corrosive. That's all been fixed now, and it's all taken care of, so the machine is ready to go. Let's take a look at it finally, all put together. Here the Lloyd's is all back together. Let me turn on the power. See the light came on. There it is in rewind. There it is in play. Now to do fast forward, you have to hold the play button down and press the rewind. That will disengage the pinch roller and allow the take-up table to work without any resistance at all. And that's it. Everything is ready to go. I'm going to put a tape on and we'll listen for a minute. This is a private tape.
1895. All of Manchuria appeared to be within the reach of Russia. Railroad diplomacy and a consequence of the...
Now, this is the tone.
...considerably increased Russian influence in the Far East. Russian ambitions in Manchuria, however...
And the speaker is under here.
...came in conflict with the ambitions of Japan.
So, there it is, and it's playing fine. The capstan, when you want to change the speeds... is just as simple. You remove the sleeve here and store it over here. Here's fast forward. Here's rewind. There are no tape lifters on the heads. Thank you for watching the video on YouTube about the Lloyd's LT612 transistorized tape recorder. Now that we know how the machine works and how it was restored, it's time to take a look at how to transfer sound from the tape recorder to the computer. And in order to do that, I want to use a separate YouTube video because some people may want to see just that process without understanding anything about the tape recorder. And we'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye, YouTube.